Hi everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the images in the visualization of the codices. I have created an empty project and I already have added the visualization to the project. And here I want to insert an image, let's say. What you need to do is to go to the toolbox and then in the basic tab, you will find the image. Drag and drop it into the visualization window. Let's wait for it to load. Okay, it takes some time with my laptop. And then here in the input assistant, since this is the first time that I'm inserting an image, I press cancel. So looking at the properties of the object, of the image object, here, let me show you some of the properties. For example, we have the show frame property. If you select it, you will see the frame around the image. You can change the type of the line, its width, and so on and so forth. But our main aim here is to select the image that you would like to have in the visualization. In the static ID field of the properties, I start to type, so I will call it image 01. I type and press enter. Afterwards, in the open window, I need to determine the location for the image, or I need to find the image. I think I have put it in the, here. Okay, this is the codices image that I want to have in my visualization. You can change the size if you wish. Let me make it maybe smaller. And then there are a lot of other properties that you can determine later. You can make it visible or invisible depending on the value that gets from some other parameter, some other variable in the code. Or you can determine whether when there is a click on the image, something would happen or not. All of them you can determine later. But for now, this is the way that you can select the image that you want to have. If I want to insert another one, okay, I do it again here by dragging and dropping the image into the visualization. Now, if you have a look here, you can see that the global image pool is appeared in the list of the categories. We didn't have it in the first time. So in the global image pool, I have all the images that I'm going to use inside my project. But the new image is not here still. So I can follow the same thing that I did for the first time by determining an ID, static ID for the image, and then associating the static ID with the new image that I want to have in the visualization. But this time, instead, I want to, show the frame. I want to do it in some other way. If you come to the menu of the project, in the view, you can find the PO used. If you select that, you will see the global image pool, which is generated automatically after placing the first image in the project here. If you double click to open it, you can see that we have our image here with the path to the file and with the ID for the file as well. Here we can add another ID, image 02. Then we need to figure out where the file is. So this time I can select this other image. And here you have the option to either remember the link remember the link and embed into the project or embed into the project. If you embed the image into the project, then when you open the project in some other place, the image will be embedded into the project and you can load it later on. Clicking on the OK, you can see the image here in the list of the images in our global image pool. Then going back to the visualization we already have here, clicking on the image, I can now determine the image that I want to display here in the list of the images in the global image pool. So this time I will select the second image. Pressing the enter, it should appear here. Let me make it smaller. And again, for this picture as well, you can determine the other properties as you wish. But this is the way in which you can insert the image into the project. You can have multiple of them. You can determine different properties of the images. Maybe I will show you some of them later in some other videos. So this is how you can import the images into the project. One more thing here is that the image pool that we had seen, again, I will show you it here, the global image pool. This one is a global one, so it means that it's accessible. The images here are accessible from the visualization in different parts of the project or from different projects as well. But if we need to have a local one, going back to the POU, going back to our project in the application, we can select to have an image pool. And for this image pool, we can determine a name like image pool 01 and add it to our application. And now in our new image pool, you can, if you wish, you can have image 03. Let's call it this time. We need to find out where the image is. Okay, so just for fun, I'm going to select my own photo and it will be here. So this image, inside this image pool 01, is accessible within this application, not from the outside. But the ones in the global image pool are accessible from all the applications that you have within the whole project. You can have more than one application in the inside the project. All right, so this is how you can work with the images in the visualization of the codices. I hope this would help you in doing your projects. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to share the video if you think that it would be useful for someone else as well. Thanks again, and see you next time.